Area.
Hello,
area,
hello,
area,
hello.
Area,
how are you?
Area,
how are you?
Area, area, area.
Area, you know me, I be worried boy. So sometimes I emulate my mentor, I go die in comedy, I go die in my mentor. So anytime I listen to him, it gives me inspiration.
When they dance,
I don't understand. Before, when you see dance, you enjoy dance, you know? You enjoy dance, but these days, I don't know the kind of dance they dance. Before you see a girl dancing, maybe to her boyfriend or to her husband, no, they dance very good. They dance in all those kind of good dance, you know? But these days, some people, I even wonder whether they are snakes. Are you a snake? How can you be dancing like a snake? You see people dancing, you know, and there's one that they are dancing like a tilapia now. I think they call it etigi, something like that. They give me, what is the meaning of etigi? So it's very, very confusing because there's one they go to the wall and just start like just holding yourself and going down. Are you a vampire? So you don't dance. It's confusing. And this dance, they dance them in church as well. That's just confusing people. They dance them in church. Come on, you just have to respect God. You need to respect God. And that's what is happening here today. So you need to respect God. Talking about church, where I'm from, Iwori, the way the pastors behave is totally different. You see, Iwori pastor will tell you, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for offering. But if you don't have your offering, put your phone, we'll sell it. God will accept it. My phone, yes. And one thing they do about newcomers, you know, every time in church they give newcomers bag of rice. If you are a newcomer today, they give you bag of rice and everything. You do your bag of rice thing. So bag of rice and 10,000 naira. Every newcomer. So they don't know that worry boys have sense. Every newcomer bag of rice at 10,000. Some people what they come twice. They go to every church. That's what they do. So it's only every newcomer. Some people do it for 5 times. Every time they go, some worry boys, they know this thing now that because every newcomer they give 10,000 and bag of rice, they will now go. Some of them now turn to gay now. They are gay. They will just go. Yeah. I'm a lady. They give them money just for the money's sake. Mm. So you don't do that in worry. You don't do that in worry. I go here. Some of these Chinese restaurants, they put food. All the Chinese restaurants like you serve yourself. Just pay one amount of money and you can eat as much as you like. Eh? Just go and eat. You want to finish your business? say that's how they do. People can eat as much as they like. Just pay one amount of money, the same amount of money. Yo. No, you don't do that kind of. If there are some business you cannot do in Nigeria, you have to be careful. If not, for 1 month you will run down. People should go and eat every time they like, and with maybe all the money that they pay. No, you don't. You have to be careful when you are doing this kind of business. You just have to be careful. I'm telling you. So there are some things you don't do in Nigeria compared to here in the UK. There are things you don't do in Nigeria. Actually, you have to go and pay for his burial ceremony already. Go and pay £1 something or something. But no, it's too much. It's so crazy. I'm telling you. This country, no. UK, nobody come here is opposite of Nigeria. So you kind of think like, how do they live here? It's so crazy. It's very, very crazy. Because when I came, I said, before you die, like, because it's like funeral, to do a burial, it is very, very expensive. That is what I'm saying. It's very expensive. So they are making people to pay. They're making people to pay for their burial before they die. It's only in Nigeria that the president is older than the country. The president is in Nigeria. So when I think about it, the Lord is very, very, very funny. Very, very funny. You see, there are police here. They are not even holding gun. Walking the policeman without a gun, walking on the road. Even in Nigeria, the one that has gun, they fight them. They fight them, not to talk of, no, you not even holding a gun. Who are you? A policeman will just come, you're under arrest without a gun in Nigeria. Mm-hmm. Don't try it. Don't even try it. You cannot. No, they cannot. People beat this, they cannot. So, that is how it is. So one day, I was walking with my uncle. My uncle, in Wari. So all these army men, they stop us. That where are we going by this late night? And they said, you know, army. Before they even say where are we going, I've already got the gutter because they were asking me to go to. I'm under the gutter. And say, so, and yeah. Because army, the fear of army in Nigeria is the beginning of wisdom. I'm telling you, army is very very crazy. I'm telling you the truth. So when they now meet my uncle, I say, what is your? I say, ah, this is my punishment already. I don't want extra punishment. No. So they said, okay, that wasn't what we were going to ask you to do anyway. I said, okay, thank God for the punishment. So they asked my uncle that if you want to jump into the gutter or we beat you 5 strokes of cane. My uncle was like, what the fuck? Say, I know my fundamental right. Funda what? No, you don't try it with army people. So when they were now talking to my uncle, he said, okay, I'm going to this dirty gutter. Let me take the 5 strokes of cane. The man said, are you ready? He said, yeah. Now go, they flogged him the first one. Yeah. Flog me. They flogged him the second one. Flog me. They do the third one like this. And they not flog. You know when something is up like fire, you know when you are getting close to fire and the fire is getting hot and you are like, you want to shift back up. So when they put the third one, fire! You know, your face change. Yeah. It's like you drinking ice cream or you eating bitter leaf soup or bitter leaf, your face starts to change. Flood me. So when they put the fourth one, the guy here now for body. As they put the fourth one, fear! I don't die! The other one was telling him, Kai, he never died. Remaining one, we'll go flog the last one. I said, no. And they now flogging the last one. And I'm like, fiah! Show me the gutter. Let me enter. I want to enter. He now enter the gutter and take the first of cane. So you can see when you are too stubborn, it gives you problem. That is just the way it is. So also, one thing I want to say now is, do all these guests they form? You don't form anyhow. You don't. I don't know. This accent of a thing is. It's natural. When you have it naturally. Not you forming it. Are you a chameleon? You're not a chameleon. You cannot change your tongue. Even if you stay here for 5 years, it's not easy for you to change your tongue. So before you come to London, when I first started university, first year, 2013 or so, I saw one guy. I didn't know that she was just here for 10 months. I didn't know. So you just feel, you know, when I first came, I didn't really know the real British accent because British accent, like, I'm trying to, you know, to figure out which one is which. So she was just speaking, yeah. One day I caught her talking to her uncle, her father, begging for money. Uncle, money don't finish you. Money, I won't buy Gary. Oh, Gary. Then I won't go to African market, buy Gary, and I won't buy a lot of things. So I overheard her. So when I approached her, I said, I thought you are from. Then no, I said, but you are speaking like I said. Say no, now you don't know that level. You know how we form now. You know, you come here and say, Even when I was talking to you, a Nigerian person, even when I told you I'm Nigerian, so you don't do this kind of things. So I'm telling you, be who you are. God created everybody equally. Anywhere you go, everybody is equal. But I don't think some people were created differently. Everybody were created the same day. But people like us, people like us that they created maybe like Wednesday morning or Sunday morning. Sorry, not Sunday. I might have answered. Not Sunday morning. Maybe like something like Tuesday morning or Wednesday night. You can see the proof for yourself. So I think the day God created me, because I talk too much. Because even when I talk to somebody, just your voice is too loud. Is it my fault? That day God created me. Maybe rain was falling. They were doing party. They are doing party. You don't know. So this thing happened in Hellfire. Devil has one watch. There's one watch. Anytime he looks at it, he knows things that are going around in the world. Things that are happening. So Devil was studying. He was studying how things are happening, and he was taking a lecture actually, because there's some. He was taking a lecture in Hellfire. So people now came to him that okay, that there are 10 people just arrived Hellfire that they need to be interviewed before they can be accepted to Hellfire, you know. So Devil said he's busy and he said he will go later. He said okay, no problem. So Devil said before he will go, let him go. He should go and check his watch to see what is happening. Excuse me. So Devil got reached there. He checked his watch. His watch is not there anymore. Ah! My watch in Hellfire missing. No. He got angry. He went to these people that just arrived Hellfire. He said he need to ask them what is happening. So he asked the first one, say, you, where are you from? Say, I'm from America. Say, no, you look like Donald Trump party side. Say, you, where are you from? I'm from China. Look at your eyes. I can see. Party side. He asked the last one. Say, you, where are you from? Say, I am from Nigeria. I am from Africa, he first said. Say, which country in Africa? He said, Nigeria. Any particular state? Delta State. Who's sitting in Delta State? Well, give me my watch. Give me my watch. You took my watch in Hellfire. Give me my watch. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you.